How you doing? We be hanging outside that world-famous broadcast center known as the Chum City Building. That'd be the galactic headquarters of Much Music East Side tonight for an intimate and interactive with a band that has mined gold and platinum, precious metal, from right across this globe. I'm talking about the Tea Party. And you know what? To see the Tea Party live is truly an experience. Tonight, it's an intimate and interactive experience. We'll take it inside right now for the Tea Party.
We'll be right back. Thank you. Believe me, it's our pleasure. A jazzy little number, a song about inspiration and love. Thank you. guys. Thank you. Thanks, my friends. Something needs to be said. We've had the fortunate opportunity of working with an organization called the White Ribbon Foundation. It's an organization that's trying to promote the awareness of the unfortunate problem of domestic violence here in Canada and elsewhere. And what's the motto? Men against women. Men against violence towards women. It's about time, don't you think? Right. So, with that being said, this is a song called Release. Thank you very much. So this next song kind of sums up the statements on our last record, this newest one. This is a song called Transmission.
Tell me what I hold in the palm of my hands. Tell me what I
think I hear it, man. Thank you.
Oh yeah, that was a Tea Party there with Transmission. That was a title track to the latest disc by the Tea Party. More songs from that album, as well as other Tea Party albums. Look forward to that. But at this point, I just want to say, guys, welcome, first of all. And I would like to take this opportunity just to introduce you to individual members of the Tea Party. You know who this guy is. On vocals and guitar, it'd be Jeff Martin. Jeff, welcome. And over on keyboards and bass, Stuart Chatwood. And on drums and other, I guess you could say other percussive, percussion-like instruments, Jeff Burrows. So you guys know the drill. You guys ready to tackle some questions? Lots and lots of questions. You're going to be okay with that?
Sure.
Okay, because I know these people here are going to be really excited. They're going to get interactive with the Tea Party. You looking forward to that? Okay. Now I know you at home. We haven't left you out. We haven't forgot about you. You're a big part of the night. If you want to ask the Tea Party a question, you're gonna need some numbers. We're gonna give you the numbers right now. Here's how to hook it up with the Tea Party, and we'll see you in a bit.
Get intimate and interactive with Tea Party. The toll-free number to call is 1-800-265-MUCH. That's 1-800-265-6824. By fax, the number is area code 416-591-MUCH. That's area code 416-591-6824. You can email teaparty@muchmusic.com.
Welcome back. You are watching the Tea Party, intimate and interactive on Much Music. Now, that was a great set, but we gotta tell everyone here that the music is only just beginning. There's gonna be tons more music coming up. Look forward to that. But you know what? I'm the host of the show, so it means I have the first question. So that's pretty good. What I wanna talk about is, I think a good first question would be, Transmission, when it first came out, everyone was talking about how, because at the heart, a rock and roll band is what Tea Party is, but how they were mixing the organic qualities with the technological influences and stuff like that. But I have to wonder about a spiritual evolution within the band, as well as a sound, I think a spiritual evolution. Because the album starts off with Temptation. There's a reference to stealing souls. The album on the whole, I think, is dark, apocalyptic, intense. But yet it ends with Aftermath, and there's a reference in there to glimpses of hope exist. So I'm wondering if there's a spiritual evolution maybe happening the past couple years.
So right now, we're throwing levity out the window.
We're gonna jump right into the heart of the matter. Some heavy stuff, and then we'll talk about fun stuff later, maybe.
Well, you know, I'm a firm believer in the fact that I think artists, you know, no matter what medium you're working in, right, you've got to come from an honest place. And at the time, the musical landscape that the band, like, we created, I had to back up lyrically with personal experiences, let's say personal philosophies that I'm still developing as a human becoming, right? You know, and I had to come from an honest place. And I was coming from a, not so much a place of being very cynical, but I was questioning a lot of things, you know. I'm very interested in a lot of, you know, I guess what people would call like occult philosophies or whatever the case. I mean, I'm searching, you know, in my Siddhartha mode right now, you know, so just trying to check it out.
The glimpses of hope reference is a pretty positive thing, so I have to ask at this point, is the band happy? Are you guys happy?
I think we are now, as we're heading into the next record. We're not faced with the same problems we had going into Transmission, so as a result, it's showing itself in the music. Like, without the lyrics even being written, there's, a positive outlook, I guess. So, it's good. There's growth there, so.
It's very positive.
That's a great sound. That must make you feel good. You know what? I think maybe we're going to go and talk to you just a little bit. So just hang on, okay? They've been hyped. They're hyped, I got to tell you. You watch much music. You know what Speaker's Corner is. Okay? Well, right now what we're going to do is take a look at a traveling version of Speaker's Corner going across the country called Speaker's Corner on the road, I believe, from Vancouver. So you have to watch and listen, and here it is.
I'm Vanessa from Vancouver. People portray your band as really serious in your photos and interviews. Are you as serious as we all think you are?
Can I say one thing here? I've seen you guys smile all day today.
No, no smiling.
Yeah, no, we're not smiling. We're dark and brooding, trust me. I mean, we're happy, you know? I mean, think about the fortunate position we're in. We get to go around the world, express ourselves, and people are getting off on it, and, you know, we're getting off on it, and it's like, we're coming from a happy place now, though, you know?
I think we're generally not happy with doing photo shoots. Yeah. You get a start back and you're just standing there all day. So that maybe that's where it gets, I don't know, misconstrued as to being an unhappy band or something.
You've been tagged too, Thinking Man's rock band or Intelligent Rock. You've been tagged with that. How much of that has to do with the fact that maybe you don't smile on photo shoots, which are dragged to do anyway? Because you have been tagged with that.
Well, that's nothing to do with that really, but I mean, there's a point now where I think there's an oversaturation of, you know, apathetic pop music, you know, in the world today, right? And so, but there's like a new breed of bands coming through, like, you know, your Radioheads and, you know, Tool and things like that, right?
You want to make a statement, right?
Yeah, you want to make a statement. You know, the three of us, we got to be able to sleep at night, you know?
Okay. And I think we're just serious about our music, and sometimes people just can't accept being serious about anything. You know, and we enjoy it more than anything, but we're just very serious about it. It's like a painter or someone who's, you know, becoming a doctor. You're very serious at things you love to do. So.
Well, we're going to take a phone call right now. Stefania, I believe, is on the line. Hello, Stefania, are you there? You want to say hi to the tea party?
Yeah. I love your music. You guys are, like, a really big inspiration for me. And my question is, have you ever thought of publishing a book of poems since your lyrics have a poetic rhythm and feel?
Yeah, I've thought about it, but I've been approached by a couple of publishers as well, but just right now, I don't have enough work to merit a book of any substance that would give anyone, you know, any enjoyment right now, even myself, you know, so I'm going to relax on that topic until I've got a bit more of a body of work to go with, so.
Cool. Okay, thanks.
Thanks for your call.
Bye.
You know, we're gonna bounce the email right now. Someone is online, they have a question for the tea party. And I believe, there we go. And it says, I'll just paraphrase it for you. Seeing as Canadian music is becoming more and more popular recently, how do you think that your band has contributed to the Canadian music scene from Screaming Daisy? I believe that's not a real name.
Canadian music scene? I think our band has gone some places that, as far as rock bands, new rock bands in Canada, you know, we've explored some other territories outside of America, and so that's bringing an awareness of Canadian rock music to other countries such as Australia or Germany or, you know, some European countries as well. And
exploring other cultures musically, right?
Yeah, exactly, like bringing that whole the cultural influence into the medium of, you know, the idiom of rock music as well, and it's turning on a lot of people that have never heard music from the East onto that type of music, and then they go and explore all the masters like Ali Akbar Khan or Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan and people like that, you know.
Most bands, when they're on tour and you tour all over the world, they don't have time to pick up fridge magnets as a souvenir. You guys managed to come back with instruments. How do you have time to do that?
Oh, you just, you know.
Ginseng?
Ginseng, yeah, ginseng.
The magic of ginseng and vitamin B. B12.
Yeah. They like that up there. And we also have a question from someone who's lucky enough to be here in the environment tonight for the Tea Party I&I. What is your name?
My name is Rob.
Okay, go ahead with your question.
Greetings, gentlemen, wherever you are. When I listen to the new album, in the lyrics I hear traces of, say, Nietzsche, Baudelaire, Machiavelli. But in particular, when you look at Army Ants, I mean, there's a definite reference to Brave New World by Aldous Huxley. But also when you really listen to it, you hear traces of 1984, and I don't know if you've heard of it, but a book called We by a Russian author.
That's true.
And I was just wondering how literature influences your lyric writing.
Well, in particular, that song Army Ants was inspired by Eugene Zamyatin's book, We. He's a Russian author, 1919-1920. He was the first outspoken critic of communism and even in Russia, so hence he was exiled out of there.
Right?
Yeah, there was a play in Montreal by some friends of mine. It's called Le Théâtre du Deuxième Réalité, and they were the first people to put on this play. They transcribed it from the novel, and it plays a big part. I get inspiration. Well, I think the three of us, we get inspiration for our music and for my lyrics from painters, poets, philosophers, everyday life, meeting, you know, just everyday people and, you know, hanging out, experiencing culture, everything, being empirical, you know.
You happy with that?
Yeah.
Okay, yes, thank you. You know what, we're gonna go to Montreal with another speaker's corner on the road, so if you can,
good.
Yeah, it's home for you now. Absolutely, maybe you might know this person.
Hi, this is Ron from Montreal, and I was just wondering, I heard you guys are working on a new album, and when's it going to be out, and what's it going to be like?
Well, we are, and it's going to be good.
Next question. No.
Damn good. Damn good.
Yeah, we're kind of in the process right now. It's like a bohemian effort, because we're jumping from studio to studio and, you know, effort to effort to put it all together. So it's gonna be a really gypsy type of thing. And musically, the new record, you could consider Transmission as being the template for where we're gonna go. But I think now that, you know, the band is much happier and we're smiling and everything, it's probably, the music would be considered to be a bit more joyous and a bit more melodic than anything we've done in the past. So look forward to that, maybe.
It's good to see you smiling. You want to see some people out there smile?
Yeah.
Okay, watch this. Okay, do you want to head outside and maybe talk to some of the people?
This is Sarah. Sarah, I believe you have a question. What's your question, Sarah?
Okay, can they hear me? If you guys, you're having a tea party, and you can each invite one person, who would it be and why?
I'm going body surfing.
If you're having a tea party, you can invite one person, who would it be?
Da Vinci.
We have one more question over here. Do you want to come over here then? Is it you? Who had the question? Oh, it's you. Okay, how you doing?
Hi.
What's your name?
Corey.
Who's that?
Okay. A lot of your videos and songs have stuff pertaining to the occult, and I'm just wondering, do you believe in it as a religion or just a mystical thing?
I don't subscribe to any one religion. It's kind of an alchemy of everything. I'm still searching. Yeah.
Do right now. Okay, we just started talking to some of the people. We're going to talk to a lot more of them inside and outside, and you at home, and lots more music too. Lots more music all after this break. We'll see you after. That was great.
Much Music's intimate and interactive is
the Toronto Tableau Ensemble, ladies and gentlemen.
This is easy to understand, my son, there is no other. I cannot pretend to love this man like my father. I cannot. This is easy to understand without our best fight. But I see a new sign, oh, and it's rising in the east. Yeah, I see a new sign rising.
I'm going to introduce to you a very, very good friend of mine from the Toronto Tabla Ensemble. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Mr. Ritesh Das.
these memories, they filled her with light. She remembered the beauty. She remembered the sadness. And these memories, they filled her with lies. prince above and she'll taste its time. These temptations are blinding desires to see that they're needs. What's real and say, sister away. Thank you very much. This has been a great year for us. Our fans, I have the utmost respect for. Thank you very much for sticking with us. Now, if I may, I'll take this opportunity to lead y'all into something that we call temptation.
Driven by the strength to
Oh yeah, lots more music and lots more talk continues with the Tea Party Intimate and Interactive.
I love the tea party.
I love the tea party.
Tea party.
The tea party. The rock.
Oh, yeah.
Real sexy, eh?
Yeah,
is that it?
Yeah, sex appeal for sure.
I love the tea party.
F***ing tea party. Only three men in the band. F***ing thing is like an eight-piece band.
So obviously you like them, do you?
A little bit.
I love the tea party. Tea party f***ing go off, man.
Scene in Sydney, Australia, about a month ago at the tea party. What do you think that guy said when he beeped?
That guy said something and they beeped it. I don't know what he said.
What do you want to talk about that? Now, you've made a lot of fans happy in Australia, of course, Canada, the US, all over the world. Are tea party fans the same the world over? Or does it vary country to country?
No, it's a common. Yeah, I suppose the cohesion would be that it's like there's an awareness, like a very open-mindedness towards all types of music. Like I judge our audience by their, let's say their t-shirts, you know what I mean? Like if they're wearing like concert t-shirts. So you see like, you know, Tool t-shirts and Radiohead and, Nusrat Fatali Khan and, you know, it's all over the place, man. And that's what I like about our fans, you know, just very open-minded and very aware of different types of music, you know?
You've been to Australia how many times now, do you figure?
Six.
Can I ask how many air miles you got? That's a lot. That's a lot. You guys want to go over the window again? Say hi to some people?
Once more, this is the tea party. What, you got some flowers? Toss over the flowers. Just toss the flowers. Just toss them. Okay, I believe this guy here has a question. You have a question? Okay. What's your name?
Chris. Just like to know what's the craziest thing that ever happened to one of your shows.
Craziest thing that's ever happened to one of your shows.
I don't know. I've had a couple of people ask me to marry them.
not me to marry them, but to actually propose for them on stage.
Can you see people when you're performing? Can you see them in the front row or the lights too? Because I'm imagining like you must see a lot of heads moving up and down, people singing along with the song. It must be a great feeling.
Yeah, well, you know, when we started out, I was kind of shy and I didn't want to look at anyone, but now I'm starting to make more eye contact, and it's great, you know, you see the communion happening.
You like the sound? It's a nice sound, nice and loud. You know what we're going to do? We're going to go to the speaker's corner just around the corner, the original speaker's corner at Queen and John, right now.
Okay, I was just wondering which one of you spends the most time looking in the mirror.
I believe, you know what her question was going to be? I believe, Jeff. Okay, Jeff, you come over here. I believe her question was, you can speak for the band maybe. Who spends most time in the mirror?
In the mirror?
That's what apparently her question was
going to be. We collectively spend as much time in it. We don't really spend a lot of time in the mirror. That's a stupid question. I'm sorry.
Just to let you know that I didn't ask it. That was her. Okay, you know what we're gonna go inside because that guy's sure the security guy's trying to hold back the barrier. It's crazy. We'll be back a little bit later. You wanna come back inside. It's crazy out there. We'll be back.
I prefer rock and roll. It's quieter.
We can talk about
question.
We can talk about it was her question apparently, but we can talk about looks. I'd rather talk about music though.
A chance? Okay. The question was, who spends most time in front of the mirror? And I said, that's a really stupid question.
Okay, guys, have a seat then.
No,
I don't want to talk about looks. I want to talk about music. And specifically, someone asked earlier about the Canadian music industry as a whole, which reminds me of the Tea Party being described as, I'm sure you've heard this, the black sheep.
of the Canadian music industry.
It's great. Quite proud
and,
of it.
And you like that, and you prefer it that way. So can you explain that?
Well, you know, I just, it's changed. It's starting to change now for the better. But over the last couple of years, I saw a lot of bands coming up in Canada trying to emulate, you know, what was on the cover of Spin magazine in America. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I just think that we've got a really unique situation here, a vantage point of looking at what's going on in America, looking at what's going on in England, and, you know, being like alchemists and like bringing it all together. And I don't know. I mean, you know, in the beginning we were accused of copying different things, which we've shed now, but I'd like to see bands, you know, just stay true to their heart and not worry about trends and, or just trying to make music just for the sake of success. You know, make it for your soul, man. Make it for the sake of art, you know?
Well done. I appreciate it, and these people appreciate that. Yeah. Right now, we're going to go to Speaker's Corner on the road. I believe it's from Vancouver.
Hi, my name's Dorian Needham. I'm in Vancouver. This question's for you, Jeff. You said one of your favorite philosophers was Friedrich Nietzsche, and I'm just wondering, if he were alive today, what do you think he'd say about the Tea Party?
That's a very good question.
That's a tad heavy.
Why? I think that, I don't know, I would hope that he would appreciate the fact that we're trying to explore maybe darker aspects of the psyche, you know, we're at a different end of the pendulum, you know, the swing of the pendulum as far as what we're trying to approach in music. And I hope he would appreciate that we're trying to take risks, you know, with what we're doing, you know. I mean, we're not exactly radio friendly, so, you know, there's one thing, right? You know?
We don't want to be friends with radio. What's happening now?
Just good to see.
Yeah. Well, like I said, it's changing, you know.
On the phone right now is Robert, I believe. Robert, buddy, are you there? You're from Mississauga?
Yeah.
Hey, Robert, what's your question for the Tea Party?
Well, I'm here with my girlfriend, and our first date was at a Tea Party concert 5 years ago, and we've seen you 11 times since. Which one of your songs would you guys, would you suggest playing at our wedding? And what's the growing rate per song?
Release. I want you to be free.
Cool.
No. I would think that. Just kidding, man. I don't know. A lot of people. We've had things said to us that they've gotten married or had a song played from our first record in this time.
In this time.
Had a
my
really
girlfriend
nice sentiment
has it in my hand.
Oh, really?
She said this one to suggest to you guys.
Well, yeah. Maybe go for that one, man. You know.
Cool.
Go for that one.
Thanks, guys.
All right.
Thanks for your question, Robert. We're going to take an email right now from Steve Edwards. He says he's a huge Tea Party fan in Chilliwack, B.C. And he says, from your recent album Transmission, Stuart did the painting on the cover. The painting is called The Earth We Inherit. Why did you choose to use this painting, and what drove you to take the cover art into your own hands? Because this is not new with the Tea Party record.
Well, we always control everything, or we try and control everything.
Big maniacs.
No, I appreciated artists that, created... I don't know, you knew what you were getting, or what you were getting was the artist's vision, totally. It wasn't like sort of filtered through a record company. So I appreciate it when like artists produce themselves, artists make their own artwork, artists are heavily involved in the video. You know, it's the anti-product thing, you know, the anti-marketing thing. But I don't know, with this album cover, Jeff and myself were in London at the Tate Gallery and we saw this painting by Turner. And we walked around the gallery separately, and we came out on the sidewalk, and we both said, some boring stuff in there, some nice stuff, but did you see that one painting? And we both talked about the same painting. That was the one that really struck us, so we always kept that in mind for the album cover. So it was sort of inspired by a work by Turner, so.
Well done. We don't want to ignore the people here tonight, so I'm going to ask someone a question right here in the Much Environment.
Hi, how are you all?
Doing fine. Where are you?
Come on.
Right over here, way in the back.
Okay.
Okay, now, in Transmission, I've noticed that your lyrics are more maybe first-person narrative rather than in your previous albums.
Yeah.
And I was wondering if that's because these lyrics are more meaningful to you, if they're more personal.
Yeah, sure they are, because... I mean, you got to figure, like, when we started and we came out of Windsor, I mean, I'd spent my whole life in Windsor up until I was 19, 20 years old. And I had no really life experiences. I hadn't traveled around the world yet. I hadn't really had a lot of meaningful things happen to me. And the thing was, is as the band went on and, you know, as I said before, we were fortunate enough to start touring and going on, and all these experiences began to happen, it's funny, like, I feel that artists have a responsibility at getting at that infinite background of emotion, distilling it into something that's perceivable for their audience, for the public. So it's like kind of a responsibility being in this fortunate position to be able to offer up opinions to the audience, and then they can discern for themselves what they think, you know?
Thanks for your question. Speaking of the audience, we're going to make a lot of people happy real soon because they're going to be playing again. Okay, so let's get ready for that. And don't go away. So much more with the Tea Party Intimate and Interactive right after this break.
With the Tea Party Intimate Interactive. Are you having a good time so far? There's still lots more music, you know that? More music to come. A little bit of talking, too, because what I want to talk about right now is, and we touched on it earlier because you played Release, and that is the White Ribbon campaign. Your involvement with the White Ribbon campaign was paved, what am I trying to say here? That the song Release paved the way for that involvement, right?
Yeah. Well, actually, Release was inspired one night. The band, we had written the musical landscape of where we were going with that. Had no words as of yet, and on the television one night, there was like a report, I think it was on CNN or something, it was going on about the condition of women's rights right now in the world, and so it focused on, let's say, the Middle East, where a lot of like fundamental Islamic movements are taking over, and when that takes over, women are basically denigrated to the point below dogs, and also what's happening in Africa, and still in some countries where there's the practice of young girls' genitalia mutilation. Then it shifted to North America, domestic violence being on the rise, you know, there, America, here, Canada. It was just kind of like this condensed thing that just hit me, and right away just wrote this, like what I perceived to be like a very simple apology, by no means, you know, like a Band-Aid or anything. It's just you know, an honest attempt to apologize for, the way the male has treated what I consider the better half of the species.
So the best part is that the CD single proceeds go to the White Ribbon campaign.
So we met with these people from the White Ribbon Foundation, and I really wanted to, we've never really done anything as far as backing up a charity or whatnot, and it was the first time that we felt really good, and our hearts were in the right place and their hearts were in the right place, and there's a trust, and I know that they're gonna take care of it, you know, and so by all means, you know, Release was for them. So.
Well done. Gotta say well done to the band. Thanks for being here. We're gonna end off right now with one more song, and I gotta ask one more time, when will the new record be released? Because Transmission was born out of a tumultuous time, but you love the end result. Yeah. So if you're happier, what's the next record gonna sound like?
Looney Tunes, man. No, I don't know, you know, I just, it's, like I said, a lot more melodic, a lot more joyous, you know, and, it's gonna be, it's going to be something very interesting, trust me.
One more time, just prove them wrong. The band does smile. There we go. You guys ready to play? You guys ready to hear the Tea Party play? One more time as part of the Intimate Interactive, the Tea Party.
Yeah.
What do you think of the show?
What's that?
What do you think of the show? Good show.
So I thought it was a very good show.
You like the drums? Good show?